My name is Dave Madsen. I have the privilege of representing the 104th Legislative District, and I'm also a proud product of what's called Path to Power. If you're not familiar with Path to Power, it is a program that organized labor has to get card-carrying union members to run for office. So I am a proud card-carrying union member that happens to also be a state house member. And in addition to raising the wage, I want to talk about the pro-worker legislation that my colleagues and I have worked on to pass through the House and that are currently sitting stalled in the Senate. I want to add something. Recently, we've been talking a lot about this song, Rich Men North of Richmond, and what it means and who can claim it. And the fact of the matter is, it's a working class song. If you listen to the lyrics and the gentleman and you listen to his comments, it's about frustrations that the working class are seeing. And in my district, it's a predominantly working class district. And that's where people are. They're saying the hell with all of you, because they don't see people fighting and advocating for them until this House came together and this Democratic majority formed into the House. We are fighting for working people. This legislation is proof of it. And the package of legislation we've passed forward, for example, House Bill 299, public sector OSHA. This is something I'm an AFSCME member, so this is something that we had advocated for a long time. And if you're not familiar with public sector worker unions do not qualify for OSHA. So let me give you an example. The Public Works Department here in Harrisburg, where people work very hard to collect our trash and plow our streets every day, they do not have the same protections as Penn Waste or private company where a municipality outsources. So it's a two-tiered system. How does that make sense? How is that fair? It's not. So that's why we advocated for this legislation. Recently, we are seeing young people, this Gen Z, I am so proud of this generation. They are pit bulls. 88% of young people want to be in a union. And one of the reasons they're so willing to organize despite anti-union tactics, despite being threatened to lose their jobs, when they interview them, they say, we got nothing to lose. We're strapped with student loan debt. We're not seeing our wages go up. Our rents are going up. They're so desperate, they don't care if they get fired. But they know a path forward is being in a union. So this House Democratic majority has passed several bills that make it easier to form a union, level the playing field, so people can simply, workers, so this is how this all works. You go to the NLRB, you work with a union, your workshop then has a vote. If that gets ratified, then you have a contract. But that's the key point to this. There's a vote. So management can make the arguments for why they think folks shouldn't be in a union. The workers then take that input and they make a decision amongst themselves about the path forward. But we consistently see this, despite workers voting to be in contracts and in unions, we see management stalling and dragging out the process so that that way these folks cannot get a contract. It's wrong and is against people's rights. But the legislation we have passed in the House and that's sitting in the Senate would make an equal playing field so that folks, when they decide to form a union, could be in a union. So I'm so proud of this group. I'm so proud to be a part of this team. And again, this is one of the most pro-labor agendas I've seen in a long time.